Okay, so in this session we are going to discuss about BGP backdoor. What is BGP backdoor and how it works? These are the things that we are going to discuss about in this session. So this is the topology that we are going to use. Just a second, I will show you the topology. Yeah, this is the topology that we are going to discuss in this session. So there are three routers and each router is running BGP in between them. That is, R1 and R2 will have a BGP connection and R2 and R3 will have a BGP connection. And R1 and R2 will have BGP and R2 and R3 will have a BGP. And R1 and R3 will have a OSPF communication between them. Okay, so this is our topology. Now, I will just say what is an BGP backdoor means. So, what it means is that if a particular prefix, okay, if a particular prefix or a network is learning through two different protocols, one must to be eBGP, one has to be a eBGP routing protocol, and other can be any routing protocol as OSPF or EAGRP or RIP, whatever it be. If a particular prefix is learning through one eBGP routing protocol and other be OSPF or EAGRP or whatever it be. So what happens is that it will always prefer a eBGP path. The reason why it chooses the eBGP is it has a lower AD value as compared to that of other routing protocols. eBGP AD value is 20, while the OSPF or EAGRP or RIP, all other routing protocols, AD value is higher as compared to that of a eBGP. So this is how it behaves. But suppose if we want the particular network has to move on through the OSPF routing protocol, at this situation the BGP backdoor can be used. So for that particular network, the BGP backdoor, with the help of a BGP backdoor, it lowers the AD value, makes the AD value higher than the other routing protocols. So automatically the network will pass through the OSPF or EAGRP, that is other interior routing protocols. So this is how it works. So basically it chooses the eBGP path. Once we mention the particular network to act BGP as a backdoor, then automatically it chooses an alternate path to pass the traffic. So this is the BGP backdoor, and let's see how does it works. So based on this topology, I'm having a three routers, and this is the router one. Okay, I have assigned the IP address. Okay, so this is, there is no routing protocol is being configured. Now let's configure first OSPF. So OSPF has to be configured between 0/1 interface of R1 and R3. Okay, so router OSPF 1, router OSPF 1, network 192.168.13.0, which belongs to area 0, and I'm also advertising the loopback network. Area 0. Okay, now move on to R3. Yeah, IP address is already configured. Just a second, I will just confirm whether to show IP protocols. There is no routing protocols. Router OSPF 1. Network 192.168.13.0. Area 0. Network 3.3.3.3.0.0.0.0 with area 0. Okay. So let's have a quick look over here now. So IP. Form a neighborship. thing 1.1.1.1. Now we can able to reach this. Show IP route 1.1.1.1 longer prefix. You can able to see it learns the route via OSPF with the AD value of 110. Okay, let's have a quick look over here. Show IP OSPF neighbor. Show IP route 3.3.3.3 with a longer prefix. It also learns the route of 3.3.3.3 through OSPF with the AD value of 110. Okay, so everything is good. Now I'm going to configure BGP between all the three routers. Let's start with router 1, that is R1. Router BGP 1. Neighbor, it's 192.168.12.2. Remote AS2. Network 1.1.1.1. Mask. Okay, all right. So let's move on to R2. Show IP interface brief. Router BGP 2, neighbor 192.168.12.1 with remote AES as 1, network, no, I don't need any sort, okay, if you want we can also add it, that's not an issue. Okay, so next is neighbor 192.168.23.3 with a remote AES of 3. Okay, so next move on to R3. What happens over R3 is router BGP 3, neighbor 23.2 with a remote AES of 2, network 3.3.3.3, mask 255.255.255.255. Okay, so now we need to focus on two things. One is by R1 and other is R3. Show IP route 3.3.3.3, the longer prefix. Still it learns via 3.3.3.3 through OSPF. It needs to change. Let's wait for a couple of seconds. IP route 1.1.1.1. Yeah, it learns. So obviously it also has to learn. Yes. Now if you look it over here, now the network 3.3.3.3 is learning via BGP routing protocol with a AD value of 20. So what happens is, although the prefix of 3.3.3.3 from R1 has a single hop between the OSPF. If you look at over here, from R1 to R3, if it travels by OSPF, it has a single connectivity. So directly the next hop is a R3. But if it chooses a BGP, it needs to move via AS2 and then to AS3. Or we can say to be as a multi hops. So R1 to R2, and from R2, it has to move on to R3. Although it chooses a longer distance, or it needs to pass a more router information, more router it has to pass in to reach a particular destination, it chooses that path as compared to that of a OSPF. The reason is it has a lower AD value. The BGP has a lower AD value, so it chooses. So If there is any sort of VPN connectivity or is there any particular network between them, you need to use, that is, from your perspective, from your topology, you want this particular network services has to be used through OSPF, then you can use this BGP backdoor method. Let's have a quick configuration about BGP backdoor and check whether how does it works or not. Okay. First thing, go to router R1 and move on to BGP configuration network. You are giving the parent network, that is in R1, I am giving the R3 networks interface 3.3.3.3 with a mask of 255.255.255. Okay, backdoor. So what does it mean? So with the BGP routing protocol for this particular network, you choose the BGP as a secondary link. Or you can also say it as, don't choose this as a primary link. So this is what it means. So let's move on to R3 and do the same. BGP, sorry. Router BGP 3 network. Here we are going to choose from R3, we are going to choose this network R1. So R1 network 1.1.1.1 with a mask of 255.255.255. Choose this as a backdoor link. That's it. Now just move on to R1, show IP route 3.3.3.3. If you see, you can able to see OSPF network for 3.3.3.3. Prior to that, before that, you can able to see this route learns via BGP. Now the same route learns via OSPF. Okay, so you can check the same over here. You show IP route 1.1.1.1 with a longer prefix. So the same thing over here, it chooses a OSPF. So let's have a quick look by shutting down the interface between the OSPF connectivity. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut interface fast Ethernet 0/1 in R3. Shut down. Okay. Now let's have a quick look over here. .1.1.1 and a longer prefix. Now we can able to see the same network. You can check in R1 also. Show IP route 3.3.3.3 with a longer prefix. Yes, it has been changed now. Okay. If you have a look at over here for this network 3.3.3.3, now it's learning via BGP, but you can able to see the AD value has changed from 20 to 200. But if you have look over OSPF, it has a AD value of 110. So since 110 AD value is not reachable, it chooses a next higher AD value, which is 200. The reason why it chooses a 200 is we have make this network 3.3.3.3 as a backdoor. So which means it changes its AD value from 20 to the IBGP AD value, which is 200. So this is what a BGP routing protocol, this is what a BGP backdoor is all about. So that's it about BGP backdoor. You can also use a metric value instead of BGP backdoor, but this is also one of the ways to configure it for any particular prefix to learn via IBGP routing protocol as compared to that of IGP routing protocol as compared to that of a BGP routing protocol. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Until next.